In 1739, the German pharmacist Martin Wolf discovered uranium. At that time, he named the element after the planet Uranium. Since then, many other scientists began to study uranium and found out that this element holds a lot of secrets. Uranium is a silver, radioactive, dense, flexible, and malleable metal. This chemical element has atomic number 92 with three main isotopes, uranium-234, uranium-235, which is used as a nuclear fuel, and uranium-238. This is a reasonable abundant element on our planet. It can be found in geological environment, always in combination with oxygen. Pierre and Marie Curie's experiments gave name to the phenomenon uranium presence of radioactivity, and Ernest Rutherford found out that a particle affected by spontaneous radioactivity can give rise to the new chemical element. In 1939, at the very beginning of World War II, two Austrian physicists discovered the nuclear fission process and its energy potential. This has changed the way science sees power generation. At this time, they used uranium for military purposes because nuclear fission could release energy on a large scale and cause great damage to any enemy. Fission is more effective if uranium-235 is used instead of 238, but there is a catch. You see, out of all the uranium that exists on our planet, only 0.7% is uranium-235. It is extremely important to separate it from uranium-238 in a purification process known as uranium enrichment. In 1940, the United States began the Manhattan Project with the goal of trying to build a bomb equivalent to the explosion of 1,000 tons of dynamite, capable of decimating life in a large area. On December 7, 1949, when Japanese attacked Pearl Harbor, in the United States, the US government commissioned the production of two bombs, one fed from enriched uranium and the other from plutonium. On August 6, 1945, the first atomic bomb in human history was dropped in the city of Hiroshima in Japan. There were 135,000 deaths with the explosion. It is impossible, however, to calculate the number of deaths in the coming decades because of the consequences of radiation. 3 days later, the second bomb was dropped in the city of Nagasaki, in which 64,000 people died. That's how uranium changed the world. I'm not saying changing for the better. Despite the benefits that this element brings, it can cause serious damages when used in the wrong way. So, what happens when you touch uranium? If your body comes in contact with uranium atom, do you know what happens? Nothing. Okay, let me explain. Amazingly, a small amount like this is not harmful to your body. Despite the power of this element, any atom would not result in significant damage to the tissues of your body. If a cell is killed by radiation, it will quickly be replaced by the body itself. In fact, depending on where you are, there are probably many uranium atoms around you. This is because the element is naturally present in the soil and is not dangerous. WHO determines that the daily dose of uranium consumption is 0.6 micrograms. The fact is that using uranium to produce energy has higher productivity than other forms of energy. To get an idea, uranium-235 produces about 80,000 times more energy than mineral coal. Furthermore, the process does not generate polluting gases or compromise the quality of the fresh drinking water in a certain region. The process is done with sea salt water, so nuclear energy is considered an energy of the future. Just for you know, in France, almost 80% of energy production comes from the nuclear power plants. The drawback of this type of energy is the pollution of vegetation with a toxic gas called radon. The gas can attack the skin of the people near the extraction areas, causing lung cancer. Radon is the number one cause of lung cancer among non-smokers, according to the EPA. In fact, radon is responsible for about 21,000 lung cancer deaths every year. If you have learned something new today, don't forget to give this video a like, share, and subscribe.